Clint Magada. I'm the Executive Creative Director of Graphica. So we are a digital marketing agency / social media marketing agency. We cater a lot of service from social media management, e-commerce. We also do photography, videography. Basically, kami yung one-stop shop solution for business owners, for businesses who want to scale online through all of their digital marketing needs. We are also a freelance agency. So actually, what we'll walk you through right now today is yung operations namin on how to be actually a freelancer and how do you scale your brand online also with the help of our service. So we have actually dalawa yung pitch or angle na we would like to with our agency on how to earn online. First is how to be a freelancer. No, actually, we are actually a freelance agency. So most of our people, photographers, graphic designers, mga social media managers, editors are actually freelance. They also work from home. And most of them are actually working students. Since they are very close to my heart, since I also started the agency back 2022 as a working student. I understand the challenge of financial challenge, especially during the pandemic, where maraming jobs ang nawala and marami yung challenge during the COVID-19 pandemic. Not just for people, individuals, also for business. That's why I started actually Graphica Digital Marketing to help yung not just yung mga business owners but also for freelancers and for creatives and talents to earn while they're at their comfort of their home. So actually, I started my this business. The agency actually is 2 years old now, but I've been working as a social media manager and a marketing freelancer during my second year in college. That was around 19, 20 years old of my time. So from there, actually, dun ko natutunan yung mga skills. Actually, I started working. There are actually a lot of freelancing sites during the COVID-19 pandemic where people can find jobs, project-based jobs, online jobs, you know, freelance jobs. Most of them actually Upwork, Fiverr, etc. Doon ako nag-start actually ng career. And actually even Facebook groups, there are a lot of projects online. So from there, I work in those freelancing sites. Then eventually, I started to build my own clientele base na rin. My own project based, and I started my agency. So as of now, I'm proud to say now we have at least 12 people in our agency, and we're still expanding. So we have partnered now with a lot of brands from different niche and different industries, from skincare, food sector, food manufacturer, cosmetics, service based, real estate, etc. So basically, we get to work and expand your portfolio. And at the same time, you can get to have this experience then working at home, comfort, without, you know, having to travel, commute, no? So, yeah. Yung the funny thing about this, start out, is this is intended to be a sideline. Because besides, while I'm working, while I'm studying, I also have a part-time work, no, in Makati. So I get to travel also there. So as you imagine, very stressful, very challenged. And from there, actually, I get to learn experience from my old project, and from there it becomes unnatural na may mga clients na lumalapit bigla. No, we experience talaga at time na there's actually very low yung sales ng clients, actually very dissatisfied yung clients. But the most important thing na natutunan ko from my experience, no, while I'm starting the agency, is yung commitment to excellence and yung determination, tiyaga, and sipag. That's the most important quality na I instill sa sarili ko. And from there, actually, proudly to say na as of now, we're expanding our service and our team. And started to idea na why not start this as a business in a way. In a way, hindi lang ako, kasi I started as a one-man team. So ako lang usually nag-work and my sister. So in a way, parang I saw na this can be also be a potential for growth and business. Na you can be, you can get a lot of projects and clients. At the same time, I can parang help other people. I'm helping na yung mga businesses on their social media and their digital marketing. At the same time, I'm also helping freelancers and yung mga students to find jobs. So it's a balance na I'm practicing right now, even as of now. So yeah, that's the foundation of our business idea. Since during naman ng pandemic, very ano naman, online classes yung setup. So di siya ganun ka-demanding. So I'm looking for syempre, pero dun sa pandemic, maraming earnings yung nawala. My parents are actually, since hindi naman ganun kadali din maghanap ng trabaho nowadays, parang I need to help my family, my siblings din, and parang for me, it's a responsibility din na to find ways to generate income and revenue. Since sayang din time, I'm just at home, di ba? At all, you know, during the pandemic, 2 years tayo nasa bahay, maraming nasa stress. Raming na babaliw dahil sa stress ng ano ng confinement, dahil nasa bahay lang sila, restricted sila, hindi sila makalabas. So in a way, I find that parang I can find things na productive. I started working dun sa Glorietta at a company, no, and na-realize ko, while I'm traveling, very time restricting. Gising ka ng maaga, 6 a.m. to get at your office at 8 a.m. dahil traffic and rush hour. Tapos uuwi ka ng rush hour gabi ng 7, time out 7 p.m., 8 p.m. makakalabas tayo. Makauwi ka sa bahay mga 9 p.m. Then yung the rest of the time, is itutulog mo na lang. Then I also have this study, so I need to finish yung mga work, ay yung mga academic task ko during middle night, madaling araw. So it'll be very demanding, very stressful. So I started also from there. The idea is, why not start an agency? Since I have the skills naman na in graphic design, copywriting, video editing, photography, and photo editing, why not start a business? Then na control ko yung oras ko, na hindi ko na kailangan mag-commute, mag-travel 8 hours a day. And also, I can help then people, na mga creatives, creative people like my team, and businesses to scale online without, di ba, without being masyadong mahirap mag-travel, mag-commute, etc. My family, actually, my mother is a housewife, but she's also a business owner. We have this small sari-sari store, actually near Bago Bantay lang, and our residential is near our office. So we have mga business small computer shops, yung Piso Wi-Fi, Piso Net. She also has this sari-sari store. Meron din silang mga apartment. From actually doon ko napulot yung business minded ko din siguro na characteristics from my mother. And we also have this father naman is actually a seaman sa abroad. So he works as a chef sa ship, no, sa tanker ship. So actually during the pandemic, medyo naging mahirap sa part namin, since my father actually since the restriction, hindi pwedeng lumabas, and yung tourism was actually low. So in jobs are actually very hard to find during the pandemic, kasi nga due to the health restrictions, the quarantines and etc. So it becomes very challenging to us to survive and sustain financially. So in a way, parang I find this as a avenue or as a way para for me to elevate and to help then my family. To our daily operations of how we do digital marketing with Graphica Digital Marketing Agency. So when we start, we have these meetings weekly with my team. So Kate here is my social media, senior social media manager. So what we do is we plan our content. So Kate will introduce to you how we do content planning and content scheduling.
So this is a content calendar from one of our clients. And here is the content that we will be doing. And then here, nakatrack siya yung status and then yung date on when it will be published, as well as kung ano ba siya. Is it a product? Is it an event? And then here's the platform. Kung cross-posting ba siya, kung saan ba siya ipopost, sa Facebook, sa IG, or sa TikTok. And then these are the people that is assigned sa magagawa nito. But here, another one is our Google Sheet planning. Here naman, we include if photo, if reels, and if ads yung gagawin natin. Kasi this is very important and very crucial yung content calendar. Kasi dito makikita ng client kung ano ba yung gusto mo sa kanilang brand. Kasi you need to be also proactive kapag social media manager ka and if you're the one doing the content calendar. So you need to adjust and you need to see unforeseen factors that may affect your content. And also, very crucial yung role mo kasi you need to establish credibility and trust to your audiences. So from there, you can choose variety of contents. If you want to publish photos, reels, carousel posting or carousel photos, as well as kung ano ba yung ads. So this will show the variety of contents na ipopost natin for our brand's social media pages. And lastly, this will serve as a database, data-driven insight kasi itong content calendar. So from here, we can track for the past months if ano ba yung naging effective and most engaging for our clients. So it also promotes collaboration. It's not just between you as a social media manager, content editor, but it also let the client to work efficiently. Makikita nila kung ano ba yung ipopost natin and so they can prepare. So if you're a social manager, I encourage na you should be proactive, you should know how to solve problems. And you need to also adjust sa environment. And also, you can put here yung mga holidays. Pwede mo siyang i-plot. Like here, we have Christmas Eve na greetings on the 24 na i-release. Ayan. And then, we also have here na reels naman na parang Merry Christmas from this brand. And as well as other services that we want to post online.
For the content development naman, here is the sample of our works. I think this is a 2-month work namin sa client namin. So basically kapag content development, once we already got the content planning, ngayon i-execute na natin siya sa graphics in which kailangan natin i-consider syempre yung brand and yung identity nung product, and then at the same time, kailangan ma-project natin kung ano yung kailangan ng market, since it is very important to identify the user's need as well as yung goal and yung target mo. So for this one, makikita nyo na yung brand consistency when it comes to their swatches, the color, and yung mga other use of text, the font, and other elements, especially yung pag-highlight ng products as well as yung mga users natin.
So we also handle yung mga e-commerce since ayun nga po, maraming clients na nag-handle ng mga businesses. And this is one example po. So we're handling the Shopee of one brand. So pagkatapos po ng mga graphic designing and copywriting, we also post it here. Pero since ayun nga, one recommendation is when we're posting here is, for example, itong product na to is, you have to be concise and you have to state all the benefits lang, ganun. That would really catch the audiences.
Now for the next part of actually what we do in our operations is we do photography and videography, content development and content, photography and videography. Na kailangan, if you're a business, if you're a food service business, or either you're a product business, it's important na kailangan laging attractive and appealing yung social media contents nyo online. So in a way, we help you create your with my photographer here, Mark Rueda. So, Mark.
Yeah, so what we're doing right now is that since we're in graphic, hindi lang kami more on online, we're also doing pre-prod, post-prod, and the production mismo. So, when we're doing photoshoot, hindi lang kami basta humawak ng camera. We're also studying the principles of design, the white spaces, the rule of thirds, and other compositions. So, after we do the photography, we go directly to the pre-production, which is we edit the photos. So here are the one of our the sample shots that we did on the past few months. Miguelitos, the Champorado, the Ubi chocolate, and other products. So we also do touch-ups, the editing for the photos, the PR events that we're covering, as what you see here in our skincare brand. And we also do the cleanups on their modeling shoots. And what you see here. So here in the photography, it is also very crucial that we do proper planning, like what you see here, the inspiration board that we plan. So hindi lang siya basta-basta pictures, hindi lang siya basta-basta mga photo, hawak ng camera, okay ka na. You just have to make sure that you do that extra mile for your clients.
When we started the business, no, way back late 2021-2022, the common challenge was establishing yung credibility and yung integrity of the business. Since we're a startup, no, and actually with our experience pa dati, we're a startup agency. And ako rin, I was a startup marketing professional. Actually, I'm still working pa nga dati. I am still studying pa nga dati. So in a way, establishing your credibility and integrity, especially when right now I'm meeting with mga CEOs, chairmans, presidents, you need to parang create this parang professional integrity and credibility. Yun yung hindi namin na overcome before since we're students, especially working students, medyo hesitant yung ibang clients to work with us, no. But nga, due to time we practice yung parang yun nga, master yung craft namin. Na-master namin yung experience. We attended a lot of workshops. We got a lot of experience from previous projects. And as of now, we're very happy to say na the team is very proficient and excellent in terms of handling their accounts and their social media, the service itself. Dahil talaga, when we started, we only catered to parang specific service. Specifically, actually, yung mga dati, mga graphic design lang. And actually, dati talaga super binabarat. Binabarat yung service, lalo na sa mga, yeah, I'm not gonna say yung mga specific na mga, pero yeah, very, lalo na sa Philippines, very price conscious yung market, and very, I'm gonna say barat yung mga tao minsan. So, the challenge was dati, since nag-start kami, very onti lang yung leads and clients namin, so in a way, kumakagat kami sa mga, sad to say, but I think most freelancers nowadays are nakaka-relate sa sinasabi ko na kinakagat namin yung mga mababang price o mga projects sa mga actually less than 500 pesos, 200 pesos, some are actually 100 pesos. No? So in a way, but yung naisip namin doon is dapat alam mo yung experience, alam mo yung value mo as a professional. And you get to set yung standards na you want, ideally. Hindi lang basta-basta parang kung ano lang yung pumasok, yun na yung kukunin mo. You also need to identify na, is this worth it? Is this worth it of my time? And is it worth my, is worth the paycheck ba in a way? That's what the saying. So, in a way, yun yung naging challenge, very, since bago kami noon, we get to be, barat, nababarat yung dalo. So usually yun yung challenge during the first years of our. We adjusted, no, actually dun sa challenge na yun is with our experience naman and with our people. We tend to see na ito yung quality of our work na we produce, ito yung service na pinaproduce namin. In a way, people get to see yung output na ginagawa namin. So in a way, hindi na kami yung now, hindi na kami now yung parang we have this parang standard. You know what you want. You know to get what you want, and you know your value as a professional. That's the most important thing to overcome this challenge. Know your value, know your worth. If you say that this is how much you're paying for their service, you get to be confident to say that this is my price. And if ever negotiation wise, wag niyo masyadong baratin sa sarili niyo. And syempre, nasasanay yung mga tao na binabarat nyo. For example, a logo project, pabaratin, ganyan. Huwag nyo sanayin yung mga tao na undervalue you, to undervalue your service, and to undervalue you as a professional. Know your worth, know your value. That's the, siguro, the challenge na. Ayun yung solution namin to overcome this specific challenge. Know how to say no then. Sometimes, although a project is siguro gustong-gusto mo, pero yun nga, may mga terms. It's not just beyond yung price eh. it's beyond upon yung communication, yung terms of your agreement with a specific client. So in a way, hindi lang sapat na yung price lang yung hindi kayo nagkakasunod at magkasundo kayo sa lahat ng bagay. And they know how to, alam mo kung ano yung value mo sa table when you're doing negotiations with your clients or with your potential clients. In a way, if they doesn't agree with your with you, learn how to say no. Although we are a startup agency with almost we are actually on our second year this January. But as of now, we have worked with almost 60 plus brands in different niche and different industry. Actually, most of them are actually from the cosmetic industry. We also work in the service sector, food sector, food manufacturer. We have been working with corporations now. So in a way, I tend to still think na we're still a startup. In a way, we don't. Parang still being down to earth, being humble on what you do is the most important thing. Because that's what I learned actually while I'm watching yung mga videos of successful mga business owners, mga brand owners. They still consider themselves as a startup. So although now we've been busy, actually, lalo na ngayon, Christmas, there are a lot of brands na they're looking to expand their marketing activities during the peak season, like we call it bear months. We're very humble pa rin, down to earth in our beginnings. And we tend to look na we're still a startup and how we interact. Actually, since we're working students, we tend to work parang na kami gumagawa ng school project. So in a way, yung interaction is genuine, is real and authentic. So in a way, we get to connect din. That's the most important thing. Connect with your people, connect with your, with your team. Start a business, it's a combination of trial and error and challenge talaga. So one thing sana na alam ko siguro pero now I'm practicing is yung how to be adept in terms of finance management, because that's a key important role when you're starting a business. Because in the end of the day, if you're a business, you need sales, you need to be finance, you need to manage also your revenue and your finance. So that's something that I learned naman from my mistakes. Sometimes talaga when I'm starting, I tend na walang kita or something because there's a problem or there's a challenge, no, na hindi mo na monitor or na track. To aspiring entrepreneurs, no, this is my message to you. Maraming nagsasabi siguro dyan na you can't do it, or maraming negativities, maraming doubts. Since yun nga, risking, there's actually a risk when you start a business. Hindi yan madali. Unlike, siguro nakikita nyo, you need to do first is your research. Kailangan dapat you need to research your business model. Tama ba itong inapasok ko? Ano yung market demand from here? Second is you need to have a strategy. Hindi sapat na iaasa mo na lang lagi. You need to have a strategy when you're doing your business. You need to have a model na you can rely on. Hindi yung basta-basta lang na susubok lang mag-business. Because you need to invest . Hindi yan basta-basta . And yung investment na yon is not something na madaling makuha. So in a way, you need to be strategic, you need to do your research, and at last, 3, you need to know your market. As a marketing professional, it's important, it's dire important na alam mo kung ano yung need ng market mo. Marketing is not about just parang selling your product or service. It's about building an emotion to your target market. It's about tapping the interest of your market. There are a lot of brands nowadays na tumusulpot lang na parang kabuti. And most, actually, marami rin business nagfa-fail, sad to say, even with digitalization. So in a way, you really need to have this unique value proposition, unique selling points sa business mo, and with research and having a concise and effective strategy, that's the most important siguro na I can say. Have this is social media for interested freelancers who are looking for creatives and talents, young professionals. If you're a working student who are willing, who are interested in working with a creative agency to expand your portfolio and knowledge, and most especially to earn while at your at the comfort of your home and while you're doing your ano, you can apply to us, no, at our Facebook page, Graphica Digital Marketing. And if also you're a client or a business owner who is looking to scale their business online with effective content social media strategy, Graphica is your one-stop shop solution. If you're looking to, if you're looking for an agency to work with your website, to your social media, with your ads, your e-commerce, Shopee, Lazada, TikTok shop, we are your one-stop shop solution. So like and follow us on our social media page, and you can also reach to us through our email, graphica.philippines@gmail.com.